Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition. Blind the Black Pits. And now we can zoom in and out. I wasn't able to before. Alright, so we have some money. Before I buy anything, though, I want to check on our friends here.
Certainly.
Guy's still here. He wanted me to pass on a note. I wonder if they grant me space to open a small shop here, Owen says. It could be called Owen's Second Shop. You could sell gems, Carlos says. I didn't see any being sold. Well spotted, Owen says. There's clearly a gap in the market waiting for Owen's Second Shop to fill it. Well, I can't talk to these people. I guess at some point there'll be someone in here. Let's see what our next foe might be.
Are you prepared to face your next match? Whenever you face spellcasters, be sure to eliminate them first. Without their support, the other combatants will fall more easily.
Thanks. Yeah, I kind of failed to do that last episode. Alright, so spellcasters. Well, our cleric has silence ready. I don't think we use any of our potions of healing. So we have some money. Just over 2,000. I take it from the quivering in your jaw that you have need of me, Elan says. Traveler's robe, okay. Versus slashing. Crushing. Can't afford this. Cold resistance. Electrical resistance. I don't remember even seeing these. Boots of the North, the Frost's Embrace. Stranded by his company for a sack of gold, Daviol the Frozen was left for dead in the midst of the Great Glacier. His dying curse echoed across the barren wastelands to the ear of Oryl, goddess of winter. She smiled upon him, and his bare body was protected and preserved by his newly enchanted Boots of the North. With them, he crossed the ice land in pursuit of his would-be murderers. Driven by rage, Daviol took his revenge upon his previous friends as they warmed themselves in a tavern of the closest city. After his thirst for blood was quenched, he continued to travel the frozen land, never to be seen again. Cold resistance, yeah, plus 50%. And then this one. Boots of Grounding, Talos's gift. Untold years ago, the fortress of the Star Spire Peninsula was placed under the direct torment of Talos when a favored storm herald was murdered there. Talos promised the destruction of the city by earthquakes, its isolation by tidal waves, and the death of its citizens by storms. One pair of these boots was bestowed to ensure that none but a single man would survive to tell the story of his wrath. Later, travelers seeking fortune in the ruined city came upon an aged man. Do you know the aged man? Okay. Maddened by the continuous destruction around him, the boots he wore would carry to many a distant land the legend of a city consumed by a god's rage. That's electrical resistance plus 50%. Sorry guys, my voice is a little scratchy. I'm not sure what I should choose. I mean, missile attacks and breath, I guess. I want to try to keep her away from slashing attacks and crushing attacks.
Hmm.
That doesn't really help that much. This helps a little versus missile. Oh yeah, I forgot. Someone has a slave ring. Look at that. No matter how hard you try, you cannot remove this plain iron ring. Baloth must have had Najim place it on you when you were first transported to the Black Pits. This item cannot be removed. I suppose, remove curse wouldn't help any either, would it? Lovely. So, we only have space for one ring then. Not like I'm gonna buy any this time, right? Yeah, we can't afford. A wand of fear. I mean, if I get that, we're not getting much else. So here we got light, or heavy armor, light armor, potions. What's this guy sell again? Scrolls. Okay, and then we got different kinds of weapons. What does he sell again? Range weapons.
I am here.
I don't want to say something. She knows this one. I think she's the only one to level up. Last episode.
It is done.
If we should spring for a wand of frost or save our money. What does a shield amulet do again? Armor class 4 plus 2 bonus versus missile. I got a wand of frost. Not you. But I gave it to her. Okay. Hopefully that's worth it.
Done! Are you ready to spill blood on the arena floor?
Oh, you can go back and fight another bat, like an earlier battle, and not go up to the next tier. What if we go like... We can't walk, okay.
Ha! You have returned!
Yeah, I'm ready.
Are you ready to spill blood on the arena floor?
We got spellcasters, or a spellcaster.
Behold! Your next adversaries are a pack of punchy hobgoblins I picked up near Waterdeep. I promised them freedom if they perforate you, so they're just itching for a chance to escape. Either that, or my delousing spell needs work.
Just hobgoblins? So we had casters. We're gonna have a hobgoblin spellcaster? Redwater Warrior.
I
Huh. You think these might be spellcasters? These ones in the middle?
To battle!
Forward march!
I am here.
What are you doing? Who's casting that? Was that him?
Onward!
Oh. I haven't been watching this either. Redwater Wizard? Who's that? I will silence you. Oh, there's another one. She's still casting that? Oh, God.
Certainly.
And you're still casting that. She's getting interrupted, I guess. Rianne. What's going on with Rianne? Did she get it off in time? Alright, she's unavailable.
I am here.
Okay, we got Warrior, Archer.
Your concern? To battle!
Oh, he's down. Ah, this is getting bad.
Yes?
I kind of want to run to the wizard right now, but these two are almost dead. Oh, one's almost dead.
To battle!
Okay, now get him.
To
battle!
And finally...
Forward march!
Oh, he's healing himself. I hate that. Oh, we still got this one. Sleeping.
To battle! It is done.
I can attack the sleeping ones again, are we?
Goodness! The look on their faces when they realized they would never again see those disgusting dens they call home. I think that deserves a bonus.
Okay. Pretty bloodthirsty of you, but okay. Alright. Nobody can level up. I got 2,000 gold.
Indeed.
Howdy, Meryl. What can I do for you? Just a couple more of these. You really haven't used much of them. Maybe some antidotes. Probably really be worth it for oil of speed. Or do we have access to haste? I'm trying to remember if that's a second or third level spell. Hold on. I think it's third. That's third, yeah, I don't have access to that yet. So a couple oils of speed then? Oh, that's not it. That's bound to help a little bit with these fighters here. You haven't taken the strength potions yet either. Okay. Some pretty tough battles. Alright, let's run back. We don't have much left with money.
It is done.
See if the others have anything to say. This is boring. When do we fight again? Sam John says. Should we be trying to get out of here? Says William. No, think about it. If we were free right now, what do you think we would be doing? Sleeping! Krankor says. We'd probably be fighting, Sam John says. This is just a more efficient system. We don't even have to walk. We wouldn't have been walking if Krankor hadn't set the horse and cart on fire as a distraction, William said. Krankor says, I learned it from you. William says, I haven't set anyone in our group on fire yet. Sam John says, being on fire is part of being on the team. Okay, remind me not to join their team. That might be it, so... still nobody in this cell. Hi again.
Are you prepared to face your next match? The best way to stop a river is to cut it off at the source.
The best way to stop a river is to cut it off at the source. Is he still referring to spellcasters? The river, the flow of magic, or something? All right. Do we have access to all of our spells? She never cast that. What about sleep?
Your concern?
Yeah, it looks like we have access here to stuff. We gotta get the magic users out of harm's way, is what it is.
Indeed.
Ah, you have returned!
Are you ready
to spill blood on the arena floor?
Let's go, you bloodthirsty fool.
I do enjoy toying with lesser spellcasters. I captured this insolent little necromancer running for his life outside of Menzoberranzan. How we got there, I don't know. But he does summon skeletons with supernatural speed.
Okay, take out the spellcaster first, stop the river of skeletons, got it. Lurk. Okay. All attack, and then see if we can silence him.
Yes?
I don't think sleep works on skeletons. I'm not sure. Hopefully he's silenced now.
Onward!
Oh, he still charmed them. What is he, deaf? Oh, he's silenced. So he must have reflected the spell. He casts horror on him. This could be going better. Okay. They keep going off and not attacking. And I forgot to cast Oil of Speed here. They keep just attacking whoever's closest. Don't attack who's closest, attack this guy. I don't think sleep works on them. I'll try. Unaffected, you. What's this? Spook. Charm person. Probably won't work against him. She'll hit him. Unless I move her over.
To battle! I must have aid.
Yeah, I'm gonna try. Yeah, she's... I still can't control her. I can't make her take a potion. Actually, this might work here. We got him? Alright, now finish off the skeletons.
Onward!
I am not well at all.
I see that. Down. Okay, how about...
Certainly.
How about no on that?
Certainly.
You're attacking too, right?
Your concern. Indeed. 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 It is done.
Onward!
Whew.
Uncanny! You seem to have a knack for killing things that are already dead. If only you displayed a little more flair and enthusiasm for your work.
Oh, are you complaining? Well, I don't know if that's the AI or if it's a function of the slave rings. Because I tell them to attack the Necromancer, and then they start attacking the nearest skeleton after like one hit. Please keep attacking the things I want you to attack. Alright, so Thaco reduced by 1, 12 more hit points. It's all good, but the battles are going to become harder. Same here, 15 more hit points. Our archer, 12 more hit points. That's it for now. Alright, we used a few potions. We have, what, 2250, so 2470. Let's see.
Certainly.
If we can get a hint of what's to come. I use another oil of speed and some healing potions otherwise. We should have retired and started a tavern, Cyril says. Didn't you have some terrible name picked out? Says Sam John. Crankor says, baby on a dog. What? Okay. No one in there. Hi.
Are you prepared to face your next match? A pack of warriors bearing down on you may be fear-inspiring, but the same group sound asleep is far less terrifying.
Sounds like a job for the sleep spell. Thanks. I love the sleep spell when it works. Which is usually only on lower level enemies. Alright, so... oh. Wrong person. Spellcasters didn't level up, unfortunately. One more oil of speed. Some potions of healing. Got two. She doesn't have any. Oh. So I don't know, another wand?
Certainly.
Let me just take a look at the potions. The potions. This is really expensive. Defense. Armor class 0. Pretty expensive. But this is pretty good for almost everybody. Everybody except our priest could benefit from these defense potions. I'm going to hold off on that, though. If we can put those to sleep, our next foes, it'll be a cakewalk. This time we were running out of spells, so... maybe grab a wand of magic missiles? And a wand of fear for defense. Okay. We still got almost 1,000 left. What's this? Charm and spook. Alright, I'm going to call it an episode here, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Stay tuned when we fight some warriors who can hopefully put to sleep. See you guys next episode. And always, seek adventure.